situated on the Fort Point Channel in the seaport, Boston Children's Museum is on the forefront of one of Boston's greatest assets, the ocean. While the natural environment is one of Boston's greatest assets, it's also the most vulnerable to the impacts of rising sea levels. Now, as we face the threat of climate change, storm surge, and sea level rise, the museum is taking the bold step to protect its home, waterfront, and community.
The city of Boston is uniquely vulnerable to coastal flooding due to climate change. Right now, we are seeing increased flooding, we are seeing severe weather storms, and just in general, higher flooding taking place not just in the seaport area, but in all areas of Boston.
Here we are actually in front of the Children's Museum on the Boston Harbor Walk. We are here overlooking the Fort Point Channel. We're at low tide right now, but it's quite remarkable to imagine that during high tides and king tides and storms, the water comes up all the way up to hit the Harbor Walk, and that can go straight into the museum.
As the sea level continues to rise and severe storm events become more common, what was once considered a 100-year flood must now be considered a yearly possibility for the city of Boston, and especially the Seaport District.
Boston Children's Museum's approach to climate adaptation is really nuanced and dynamic, ranging from how they're planning to adapt the building itself to the area around it to engaging people in the process and building that social resilience.
Well, the Waterfront Master Plan actually spans the entire area of our waterfront, which goes from the Congress Street Bridge halfway up the Harbor Walk and touches Martin's Park. We are currently situated at 10 feet above sea level. When tides rise, even during a king tide and certainly during storms, the water in the Fort Point Channel goes up to 10 feet and even above.
We had to envision a way in which the building and the waterfront would become more resilient to that. To be fully resilient, it's going to have to be 2.5 feet over where the ground floor is today.
Starting from the waterfront, from the Harbor Walk edge, imagine this is going to go 2.5 feet higher, and that's going to continue throughout in the interior of the museum. And on top of that, there's going to be a sitting edge that is going to be another 2 feet taller than that. So when the water comes in the case of a storm, the first line of action and resilience is going to be that this harbor walk is higher, but then the seating is going to also stop another 2 additional feet.
In addition to addressing the engineering issues of flood mitigation, the design will support the many existing uses of the harbor walk, while dramatically increasing access to the channel and harbor. The waterfront design plan will focus on activating interaction with the natural environment of the channel and harbor and exploring the marine life at our doorstep.
This will become a place where everyone, especially children, can interact with the water edge in a different way. You're going to be able to see the intertidal habitats. You're going to be able to see the seawall. There's going to be hammocks and openings in the wharf where you're going to be able to see the nature below us. So that will foster a lot of opportunities for learning and also for the community to not only be safe, but understand the habitat we live in.
It's a really beautiful landscape that will also demonstrate to others throughout the country about how you can protect yourself from climate change, from sea level rise, but also make a really beautiful and engaging educational opportunity for your residents and tourists.
Beyond the waterfront plan, the museum is also a champion of education. The museum is working to cultivate kids' appreciation of nature and ultimately care for our changing world through our rooftop garden, community partnerships, and hands-on climate programming.
Today we're just out here, we're doing a few activities based around thinking about the natural world, first of all, and maybe trying to get them to feel inspired or empowered that they have ideas and that they can do something to help the world out.
I went to Bahamas before.
Was it cold or kind of hot?
It was hot.
Yeah, it's really hot there. What do we need to do when we get really hot?
Jump in.
Yeah, exactly.
Climate change is affecting all of us all the time, and our waterfront is no exception. So we're hoping that just having a small touch point opens the door for caregivers to start to have those conversations with their kids in a very safe and supported way.
The Boston Children's Museum is leaning in. They are rolling up their sleeves and they're doing the work to make the waterfront more resilient, inclusive, and accessible by building out onto the harbor and fortifying our coastline, fortifying our waterfront, also making it more accessible to children and families across Boston.
It's really important that we as a children's museum go out and advocate. We actually tell the story of what we're going to be facing in years to come. Our role is not only to do our plan, but it's also to make sure that everyone around us and everyone in the city and all the kids and families that come here understand the challenge of climate change and how they can help us all protect our planet.
In the face of rising tides, we have the power to shape a resilient future by involving our children, building climate-resilient solutions, and embracing the power of education. We can ensure that Boston and its coastal communities thrive for generations to come. Together, we can make a difference.